morning, everybody. I would like to thank the organizers to give me an opportunity to give a presentation in front of you. My previous speakers have given excellent presentations on the structures and functions of larynx and the pathologies as well as the differential diagnosis. Now, what do we do? Our role is to train these musculatures in such a manner that not only the normal voice is restored, but the voice should have a very good quality. For example, however the skilled ENT surgeon is, his skillful surgery can remove the pathology, but I'm sorry to say, cannot remove the old faulty habits, which are actually, our job is to make them aware of these old faulty habits so that when we give them the new habits, this recurrences of the same pathologies are, so to say, avoided. Another thing that we can take, we give them such a preventive measures so that the pathology only doesn't occur. So, for that purpose, Dr. Datta has already given the detailed information about the case history, so I will not go into the details because there's a shortage of time. These are the things we do when we do voice evaluation. We take a detailed case history. We consider all these points. I go to the next. For us, for the voice evaluation, along with other medical and ENTs and other family and emotional and all the other histories, non-instrumental objective voice assessment we do first by just doing his maximum phonation time or maximum phonation duration and the Sulzer ratio, and we see the characteristics of his voice perceptually, assessing by the grab scale as mentioned by Dr. Datta. Of course, we see the loudness and pitch variations, and we do manual compression required before thoracoplasty operation. Now, when we come to the what you can say instrumental voice analysis, I use doctor's pitch. So what we do is we tell the patient to have a sustained sustained vowel for for about 5 seconds and analyze that particular sample. So now in this case, this person has got a very severe breathy voice. So he could not sustain the vowel R for 5 seconds. So I have taken a segment of it and analyze. If you want to hear his voice is like that. Can you hear it? See, this is his voice, very breathy voice. So I have taken a small segment of it and analyze. So these are the various parameters which are very important for us, like MPT, Sulzer ratio, shimmer, jitter, and mean FO, and all these things. Because this documentation has got a great value for pre-therapy and post-therapy comparison of the results, and as well as pre-op and post-op results are compared to this voice data. We also have the, we can see the severity of the characteristics of voice. For example, if it is at the zero level, this is a normal level, then one is a mild, two is moderate, and three severe. So in his case, as you heard him, very breathy voice, all his characteristics are on the severe levels. Now, we consider voice disorder into two categories. One is organic and another is functional. Organic can be divided into two, that is congenital, as Dr. Thekeda said, that congenital webs and all that, and acquired like polyps, nodules and all other pathologies. And the functional ones are habitual, like you see in pubophonia, muscle tension dysphonia, as well as the faulty habits. Of course, these habitual or functional voice disorders can lead into organic ones. Because of the faulty habits, they develop nodules and polyps, etc., etc. They also have the psychogenic functional disorders such as hysterical aphonias, etc. Now, when we treat a particular voice disorder case or a dysphonia, we make into two classifications. Number one is the therapeutic techniques for voice disorders, which are for the hyperfunctional voice cases, where there is an overuse or abuse of vocal folds. You see in polyps, nodules, or contact ulcers, and all these cases. And here, the main important thing is the vocal hygiene program, which is very, very important, like the vocal rest, voice rest, then not to clear the throat, or how to clear the throat without any bumping of the vocal folds, etc. Then the hydration, all these things, like do's and don'ts, are covered in vocal hygiene program. Then the relaxation exercises are very essential for the further easy production of voice. Then deep breathing exercises are very essential, because we require a good breath support for good phonation. So overall, all these whatever the techniques I have given, like the purpose of these techniques, actually the symptoms of hyperfunctional voice disorder cases are hoarseness, pain, then very strained, strangled voice, or there is a sort of very tired voice we have. So all these techniques, the main purpose of these techniques are to have the easy phonation, good muscle relaxation, have a good breath support, and we can avoid hard glottal attacks. So with all these exercises, all these techniques, we achieve some good phonation level, and then we can give them good intonation pattern, good projection, and they can utilize that particular habit into their day-to-day life. Now, another classification is the voice therapeutic techniques for the hypofunctional cases, that is decreased use of voice folds. It is seen in vocal fold palsies, then presbyphonias, or bowing of the vocal folds, etc. And here, the symptoms, main symptoms, are aphonia and breathiness of voice. So the aim of all these techniques, therapeutic techniques, is to have good approximation of vocal folds and have a strong voice, good voice vocal projection, and good intonation pattern. So these are the techniques we use for the hypofunctional voice cases. Now we come to the case like puberphonia. During puberty, the laryngeal growth occurs, leads to change in pitch, and in females, the pitch lowers by only 1/3 of octave, and in males, it is by 1 octave. And if it fails, then you call him as a puberphonic case. And mostly the psychological due to the lack of acceptance in the emerging adulthood. Now, the therapy techniques are used as in hyperfunctional cases like relaxation and deep breathing. But here, we give him easy phonation, which is speaking without tension leads to low-pitched voice. And of course, phonation with lowering laryngeal position, that is very important, and the half-swallow boom. Then we come to the spasmodic dysphonia, which I think Dr. Nupur will cover in great detail. I only would like to tell you is, when she gives a Botox injections or something like that, and when she refers to me, if the case is an adductor type, I use the techniques which are used for hyperfunctional dysphonia. And if it is abductor type, I use the techniques for the hyperfunctional dysphonia. Now, I would like to show you some cases. No, sorry. This is another thing I would like to say is, nowadays it is a great demand of the, corporate voice therapy, corporate speech therapy, where the teachers, singers, actors, leaders, call center employees, news readers, radio jockeys, TV anchors, and lawyers, they require a good amount of training how to use their voice successfully, without any strain, without any tension, and have a good projection as well as good intonation. Now, I would like to show you a few cases to you. This is a pubophonia case.
Case of pubophonia.
Now, can you?
On the audio, yeah. Please.
This is a pubophonia case.
Volume. माला आवडता विषय खेळ मला क्रिकेट खेळायला खूप आवडते क्रिकेट मध्ये जे मजा असते ते दुसरे कुठे नसते.
See, this is his pubophonic voice. Then in only first sitting I would change his voice and it became normal. But see, generally for the therapy purpose he should have a good stabilized voice, so he should come to the clinic till he has a very good stabilized strong voice. We give him exercises. Now you can hear him. So this is what is the
right vocal cord palsy after thyroidectomy. काय नाव आहे तुमचं? कुठे राहता तुम्ही?
She had a
त्रास तुम्हाला केव्हापासून आहे?
Thyroidectomy and right vocal cord palsy. Now the therapy is given to him, given to her. This is what is called as push-pull exercise. Now you can
mid post therapy session.
It is not yet complete. The therapy is not yet this thing, but this mid. Still, there has to be some few sessions for the voice projection and all are required. Now the next is this is the case of laryngectomy where no prosthesis is used. And this fellow talks very well on, even on phone, but now he's got some cold and cough, so it's not very good voice he's producing. Okay, I can go to the next one. This is a case of a fracture of arytenoid cartilage, and he was not benefiting by speech therapy. So Dr. Nupur did his thyroplasty. No doubt he got his voice, but the voice was quite rough and soft in tone. So I worked on him, and his voice got better projection, as well as the roughness is gone completely, and quality is achieved quite well. Can you hear?
Audio, can't please.
Can't hear. Hello.
I think we'll continue. There's some
problem. Hello, I'm sorry, the voice is not working properly. This is a very good example of a teamwork I wanted to give, so that you know both of us work together and give the try and achieve the best quality voice quality we give to the patient. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jyotsna. That was